I wasn't sure if I should rent a car. Get a van, you know, one of those van.
You should buy some traction.
Yeah, they have
the
thing.
Oh, yeah.
I would, too.
Oh, God.
His motion, it's that sideways sling, that put together with his body language, oh, I just really like it. What happens when you throw the ball? Oh, the ball gets hit really, really hard. Maybe you shouldn't do this anymore.
18th and 5,
for
the
us.
One that reminded me of Ray's idea.
Maybe book on the
bar.
Hey, folks, this is Craic Abate the Quartet. Here comes Craic.
Hey, thanks, Eric. Hey, hi. How's it going?
Why don't you grab that mic and let's make sure that we can get you into the screen.
This one?
The top, the one behind. Yeah.
That one.
Let's give that a try.
Is Jeff two of those?
Let's see if that mic does it for you.
Okay.
Are you speaking? There it is. Hey, there it is. Wow. How's it going?
Good, right.
Thank you. Just got back from Nevada City today. I was playing out there, Grass Valley, for a couple of nights, and doing some touring around that area. And it's pretty wild driving lately with the rain and stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm really glad to be here tonight, and I've got a great trio with me with Ben Stolorow on the piano. Eric Markowitz on the bass, and Michael Quigg on drums. So thank you, Eric.
Yeah, you're welcome. I said just wait till you get back here before you start.
All right, I want to just announce something about the first tune. I'd like to give you an idea. This is a tune called 18th and Vine. It was written by Art Frank, who supposedly played many years with Chet Baker. He lives in Tucson, and I met him back in New England about 25 years ago, and then he moved to Tucson, and I play there frequently, so I stopped over a couple of times, and he gave me this tune, and he was really happy that I could play it for him. So this is 18th and Vine. Art Frank. Thank you very much. Wow, it's a cool tune. He's going to be happy to hear that, hopefully. This next tune is one of mine from a new recording, which I have with me, and it's entitled Deep-Seated Reality. Thank you very much. Deep-seated reality. Had a lot of play a great a standard by the great Charlie Parker composition, Yardbird Suite. Thank you. Thank you very much. This is a nice tune. This is an original I wrote for my children, Jessica, Anthony, and Greg. It's a samba based on Benny Carter's Changes When Lights Are Low. Can we make the lights a little lower here? Up top? Barry, could you mind?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'd like to continue with a tune by Charlie Parker. It's called Bird's Blues in B flat. Any questions? Yeah, with the intro. You know this, right? Thank you. Thank you very much. How's it going? San Francisco. Yeah. Nice to be back in town. Thanks a lot for having me back, Eric. And great to be with this trio tonight. We got a lot of music to go for because we have a long night tonight. It's like 13 sets, is it? 13. Yeah. Doors locked after the 11th set. Hey, I wanted to play one tune more by Charlie Parker. It's a tune that he titles Diverse. And thanks for coming in. I hope you enjoyed the tunes.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Ben Stolorow. Eric Markowitz and Michael Quigg on drums. We gotta have another set. Thank you for sticking around. See you soon. Very much.
Hey, Patrick.
Guess what you've been looking for.
think so, but I'm from the East. I lived in the East Coast for a long, long while. I just moved over here in Boston. Yeah, but that last tune is actually in Talladega Nights.
Is it?
You know the Will Ferrell movie where he's like a NASCAR driver?
Oh, yes.
It's a comedy.
Yeah, it's a comedy. So, do you remember it? Have you seen it? Okay, if you see it, like, there's a scene where they're in a bar, and then this French Formula One driver comes in and puts that song on, and all those NASCAR guys are like, oh, I can't handle it.
That's funny.
Yeah, it's a good tune, though.
That's cool.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, Patrick,
nice
to meet you.
Good meeting you, yeah. You sound awesome.
Hey, Mike. Thank you, man.
It's fun hearing all those Charlie Baker tunes.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Well, I mean, I still have the Omni book.
Yeah.
Still going through, it's like, looking at all the transcriptions and, some of those I'm trying to learn.
Yeah, I can't memorize any new ones as much as I could 20 years ago. I just feel like I've been doing a lot of different music, you know?
Yeah.
To focus in on learning a blues like Cheryl, I just feel like not doing it. I know quite a few tunes. Glad you like it.
I should probably get here more often. I'm all the way across the country, right? So. It's like I come here once a year when you're here.
That's worth. Where do you live now?
In Fremont.
Oh, I thought you were here.
I've been in Fremont all the time. I come out here for you.
Oh, thank you. That
was probably last month.
Send a message out to the family group and showing where I'm at and doing stuff. And I had a couple pictures. My daughter says, it's a very tiny desk concert. You don't need a very tiny desk concert?
No.
So in National Public Radio, you got this office, and then they'll bring in musicians into their tiny little office. And they'll do YouTube videos of people playing. Yeah, it's like, I mean, they're literally sitting behind somebody's desk. It's bookshelves like this. And a couple of desks and
I've never seen that before.
On YouTube, I'll look at tiny desk concert. There's all kinds of stuff. It's jazz guys and Broadway and pop and all kinds of stuff. It's pretty cool.
I was at Mike's house for one night. Just to hang out a little bit with him.
He didn't come here.
No, he didn't make it. Yeah. I mean,
Okay, but one time I missed you here, I was at my son's wedding.
Yeah, that's right.
The one time you were here,
You're correct.
Up to you guys, you play the winery places?
Well, it was just the veterans. That's where the veterans home.
Oh, way up there.
Yeah, so we're supposed to go.
Yeah, yeah. So then, I mean, overtime game, they lost.
Again, overtime? Oh, my God. They are so close to being decent. And yet, so far, they just do not have it this year, baby. Not that we're not seeing it. It's interesting. It's a
transition.
But it's interesting. It's so interesting, this one, to see the heroics and the losing year. Somehow it feels very different when you are like Bonds with Kevin Hill's losing year.
Oh, is that right?
Curry seems
to be. Well, because there's championships in the
world. Well, but there was a pair of pennants. Yeah, that's part of it, I guess you're right. I mean, there's that different feel of like, you can't take away what they've done, so if they can't do it again, it's not like they're not stuck in that. Yeah, no, that's a good point.
And, you know, the thing about Steve's is
only half
the
glass.
That's all. Yeah, man.
Go on to Louisiana.
Be right back.
This team, if they manage to get together and they sneak into the playoffs, they can surprise people.
Nah, not going to happen.
Really?
Not going to happen. They are who they are. I mean, I'm not saying they can't have, they are capable of a major upswing.
Mm-hmm.
This is true. But till I see it, I'm not even gonna see it before the playoffs. You're not gonna see it.
They were terrible until like 2 weeks before the playoffs.
Well, right now they're really, you know, I mean they're not even in the play-in.
They're like two games away from it.
No, more than that.
No, after last night, they're 2 games away.
Well, okay, because that's the way it is when you're playing 500. One game, you know, flips you. But there's like there's at least three teams that have as good a shot as they do.
Yeah, there's a lot of teams with very lopsided records. So,
playing
like
two. That's the NBA. You don't have a very strong record to get to play. They're going to have to show it before the playoffs. They can't take the way they're functioning now and put the switch and suddenly become get past one round.
The seat cushion repositories.
Yeah,
so
one
repository. You can take two.
That's right. Magazine. That word magazine means like things that are stuck.
Oh, yeah.
Like in Paris, it's a kind of shop.
Correct.
And she's coming back from the trip. Bali, and then we went to Vietnam, and then this particular place in the Philippines, and then but I'm just saying, you know, it's cartoon. But still, just having somebody lay it all out, he'll meticulously lay it all out for them, a couple months in advance.
The story is a good story.
Oh, really? Oh, cool. That's the best here. Well, this one is a lot of time.
But for me, that was kind of that was borderline exhausting just doing what all we did. And trying to like plan something like 2 weeks a year, it's like day by day, but I don't have the juice for it.
And the other thing we have is her brother lives in London.
Yeah.
Right, I'm there most of the time.
PA Pied de Terre in Westland. Pied de Terre. Foot in town. Foot in town.
Yeah, Andy said that when I arrive, he's going to meet me.
Across these.
Dinner, you know? That's a fair amount of money. So you've got your pounds, it's like $85 or $90. Dollar pound is cheaper.
I need to know these things, baby. It's so funny to get down at the same time. Oh, so speaking of watching the Super Bowl, I was thinking maybe I would send Nicola say that I asked my best friend what he was doing.
Yeah.
And he said he was already engaged. What's he doing? We are strong after all, aren't we?
Maybe tomorrow will be a good day.
That's part of the reason we would have a year. That's
two tom toms would be tom tom and tom tom.
Right, definitely.
Tom tom.
This is the first time I've actually heard of
tom tom.
You know, because I've been trying to research
it. Just call it tom.
During the week, I mostly wear
shorts. I don't know.
Yes, really fun.
It was the sort of thing where my dad had to get up. He had to get up throughout the night just restart the car a couple of times.
On the other hand, this begs the question, what else did you play?
Here's the bass.
That was pretty classic.
That was weird.
It reminded me of the great salsa swing of 2020. I think it was 2021. The old camera. Bridge came open, salsa came out. Like an explosion, maybe.
Jams.
Oh, I don't know about that, because when the salsa hit the ground in the camper, you know, it's a small space, and it's wet, you know, and it was like splattering. So it gives you to see the fridge open up, this pipe just might came out, hit the ground, exploded. Okay, next time.
All the goulash are just two containers.
I know this story. I remember about but when it got fed, he got
fresh.
He's
salvaged.
How did he die?
Yeah,
I got a job at
It's a great moment that they took and they I don't know what really happened. I don't suppose it happened to be the first time you saw it. So at some point she had to draw the chicken in the kitchen. There was nothing to do but pick it up or brush it off or rinse it. No. So whatever. But you know, so you're on television. Taking food. Of course there's there's no break in the floor. It's a 30-minute straight. So nothing to do but pick it up. Start cooking. She picked it up. She said, go to the kitchen.
Yeah.
You still know? She had a lot of
right.
And this show is worth watching. Yeah. Two seasons. I guess 8 plus 8.
It sounds like it was probably
it's charming, but it's also it's gross. It's not too much of anything. It's not too marvelous. It's not too trite. There's a shop of baseball books there, and that's called The Big Foul. It's got to be Big Foul. Who do you think it's about?
Moose Scout.
Walter Johnson is the big trick. Gary?
No,
I don't think so. Don't tell me. I couldn't really tell, but I wasn't chubby guy holding him back.
A big foul.
I'm going to go to the next one. was the protection that he has. He had four. He blew so a lot of strikes because of him. He was just as dangerous as Ruth. So he was one of the guys.
I guess that's an easy one.
There's
a failure rate, right?
And they're supposed to be checks.
I know, it's not going to show up.
This sounds like stuff like some newspaper guy. The Crown of Prince, you can imagine.
Quiet hero.
You can imagine the sports record part of the Crown of Prince. Ruth was fading.
Jingle King.
Jolton Joe.
He's going to be coaching through.
Right.
so I can beetle you get like a hood.
That are collector's items. So they make nice coasters too, so you got double duty, you know?
They work well.
They do work
well. And they're non-stainable. You can put your wine on. The wine that goes disappears.
Okay, shout that. All right, so thank you all for sticking around and enjoy the second set. Organization in town that's been doing magnificent things for a decade or something now, trying to get general wage standards up and so on and so forth. So they know that in order for us to pay a decent guarantee, which is by no means a lot of money, it ain't enough to go far on, especially when you got to fly in and rent cars and fly around. So it's mostly about supporting the local performers, and so we get a little help from them the last couple months, Jazz in the Neighborhood. So help them, they're a nonprofit, and they can do it only if people donate to them. So look for Jazz in the Neighborhood, not for figure out what they do, guaranteed fair wage fund. So yeah, they're supporting this tonight. But Greg's doing all the heavy lifting.
Hey, man, it's nice to be back, Eric, to tell you.
It's great to have you here. This is a fourth or fifth time, probably?
No.
Seventh or eighth.
Yeah.
I didn't want to try to count, so
that's all. No, I always keep it in my mind, you know what I'm saying? Because someone was asking me how many times you played here. I said, about seven times.
Yeah. So I guess we got to stay in business, because, I mean, we got seven more to go before we can stay down. That's just so we can slow down. Okay.
Check. I wanted to...
Let me turn off the music here, and...
Otherwise, you have to come back on the song.
So, okay, welcome back, and I wanted to say that my wife is home listening to this. I wanted to say this. My wife requested One Note Samba. It's one of her favorite tunes, and she's listening to it in Rhode Island at home. That's where I live. So I wanted to play that for Carrie. One Note Samba.
Yeah, One Note Samba.
Yeah, it's easy. just one note, you don't have to worry about it. That's it.
Over and over.
Can I hear the first chord? We'll play that. No, what? What?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
One, two, one, two, two, two. Thank you.
Let's do my tune light speed. But light speed. Yeah.
This is a tune for my new recording on the reunion, my reunion CD. A lot of these tunes that I played the first set are on my newest one. And there's one, my first recording, 1991, it was on Candid Jazz. It was my first recording, and it was live at Birdland. And the reason that happened was because I drove it to Montreal in a wicked snowstorm, and it was 1989. And I got there, and there was nobody at the club, and the club was 2080 Jazz Club. And there was some people there at the bar, like, hanging out, and there was four or five people, and they asked me if I played in New York a lot. I said, no, but I played there. And they said, well, we represent Candid Records in London, you know, and would you be interested to do a recording? I said, are you kidding? Sure. So that's how that one happened, you know, going up there in the blizzard. So I thought maybe something would happen like that, driving up to Nevada City with white knuckles on the thing, and it did. It got me here tonight. Hey, this is a tune I wrote titled Lightspeed. I wrote a lot of these during the COVID time when I wasn't gigging much, like most of us. So I had a good time, like experiencing a different way of life. You know, more in touch with my harmony and piano, and just accepting the fact that I could still do that. You know, it was fun. And this is one of them, Lightspeed. Thank you very much. That's a song I wrote on top of Body and Soul chords, and I titled it Times Past. It's an original head or a melody. Glad you liked it.
Yeah.
This time I want to play a tune that I wrote for my wife, Carrie. It's a new tune, and it's actually called Carrie's Song. So.
Thank you.
Thank you.
to see you all tonight. Ben Stolorow on piano. Eric Markowitz. Michael Quigg. I like to finish the set with a Gene DePaul tune, and it's titled Star Eyes. And I gotta say, it's on one of my recordings with the great Phil Woods, and we, you know, it's all standards and bop tunes. So see you next time, okay? We'll be here again, I hope.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll be right back.
Here's to Carrie.
Yes, Carrie. Yeah. Yeah, she's been here once or twice.
Yeah.
Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
Thank you.
It's great you all come out tonight. I appreciate it. Thanks to KCSM also for having me on last week to talk. I was talking with Chris Cortez.
Keep in mind, if you haven't got enough, you can go to Shea Haney tomorrow. What time?
4 to 6.
4 to 6. Shea Haney, we can tell you how to get there.
Thanks,
all right.
Larry.
You bet. Thank you, Greg.
You're welcome.
Thank you all for coming out.
You guys, thanks, Don.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.
You're welcome very much.
Thank you.
This is so sweet. Thank you.
Thanks, Greg.
Thanks. Hey, Dave. See you online. See you next time.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, it means a lot to me. See you, Dave. Thanks, Dave. Thanks a lot, Dave. I hope you make it some time. I hope you get a date.
Yeah, we're good.
I love BYOB. It's so awesome.
Thank you. Sounds so good. Thank you. Yeah, I'm going first.
Touch.
Yeah.
Hey, fantastic, Greg. Really have a good time.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, we'll see you again.
You must have a website, right? I'll email you. Have a good one, Dave.
See you. Really good to see you. Got a card.
Oh, cool. Awesome. Thank you. Yeah, I'm a singer, actually. Yeah. How do you cue the guys at halftime?
It's a feel, you know?
Yeah. So you started playing and they got it.
Yeah. Yeah, they got it, you know? I have cards. I don't know where they went to. Give me there they are. Here's one.
You just chilled and hugged them.
Here's one.
Oh, thanks, Greg.
Thanks.
Cool. All right.
Thank you so much, Dave. I'm so glad it came out. Thank you very much.
Hey, my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
A memorable night.
Thank you.